Hey YouTube, continuing the basics of body language. As I already mentioned in the previous tutorials, body language is something that should be known, but not taken, you know, 100% true. Wait for 2 or 3 signals. Now, let's go to the following parts of our body. The mouth. When you meet someone for the first time, it takes a person of 3 to 7 seconds to make her judgment about you. We all do it, unconsciously. Basically, we decide how comfortable we are with that person. Remember, we are wired for self-preservation. In a nutshell, perception of possible pain and danger from that person, it will mean not very comfortable. Perception of safety would mean comfortable. Once that first assessment is made, we adapt our feelings, posture, language and tone. These first few seconds alone can make a break of relationship, whether when influencing someone in a sales or presentation situation, or when flirting with a man or a woman. And the most crucial body language signal to influence our first impression is the smile. This is also the most recognized signal in every country and every culture. The smile. Now, there is genuine smile and forced smile. Smiling indicates happiness. It's also a friendly attitude. Smiling indicates we want to communicate with someone, it shows interest. There is much more to the smile. Smiling is a learned phenomenon. Young babies don't smile naturally, as you already know. They mimic the expressions of those looking at them. By the time we reach adulthood, it has become a signal critical to making a good first impression. Smiling also has an actual impact on your physiology. We will look at that in a moment. First, let's look at the two main types of smile. It's actually what I mentioned a little bit before. Genuine and forced smile. Forced smile is a fake smile. Genuine smile involves the whole face, including the eyes. More than just the mouth, many facial muscles are in action. The most visible is tightening around the eyes. You see, this area will tighten. You will know this is genuine smile. This action around the eyes is extremely difficult to fake, and is the main signal you want to look at it if you think somebody might not be telling their real feelings. So remember, when smiling, this is what, how to say, betrays people. Look at this part. The forced smile. It is usually used out of politeness. People who put on a smile only use the muscles around the mouth. Only use these muscles. But the top half of their face remains virtually unchanged. Their smile is also less likely to be shown in their teeth. This smile could mean the person is not telling the whole truth. Do not fake a smile. Research shows that a large majority of people unconsciously recognize the sincerity of your smile simply looking at the top half of your face. Now, the easiest way to put on a genuine smile is to use your imagination. A few seconds before you smile, you should just remember some pleasant moment from your life. Imagine having a really good time with the person you are talking to, or recall a recent situation. Recall a situation when you had really great connection with somebody. Really pleasant situation for you. This will recall the feelings you had at the time and will naturally make you smile. Actually, how does this work? Now I will explain the physiology of a smile. In a nutshell, when you smile, your body releases endorphins. Endorphin is a hormone of happiness. Endorphin is something that is being placed in your hypothesis. Now, when endorphin is taken out, you are showing genuine smile. Test it for yourself. Try to smile and feel sad at the same time. Your natural reaction when someone is smiling at you is to smile back. Remember, you learned this as a baby. There is much more to it. When you smile at someone, they tend to smile back at you partially unconsciously. The endorphins get released in their body. So, thanks to the endorphins, their unconscious mind memorizes you is this person makes me feel good. A great way to break her skepticism and make them trust you. Reverse smile. This is also a good technique, but there's no need to explain it. So you see someone smile, you just smile from politeness, that is something normal. Now, you see why smiling first is essential, how it can help you greatly when trying to influence someone or trying to seduce a man or a woman. Quick summary. Closed lip smile. A fake smile to be polite, or the person is embarrassed by their teeth. Look at this part. Whole face smile. Genuine smile, indicating honesty and openness to communication, covering the mouth with parts of the face. Someone can cover it. While you're talking, they could be surprised by what you said. Or, when they are talking, they could be lying or feeling uncomfortable during the conversation. So, let's talk now about the lips. Puckered lip means that someone tasted something sour or recalling a similar feeling. Or, puckered lip could also mean a sexual interest. Now, depends on your partner, of course. Pursed lip. Pursed lip could mean worried, someone is worried about something. Disapproval, someone disapproves or disagrees with something. Swished, when you're talking, listen to you carefully, thinking about what to say next. This is swished. Lip biting. This means that someone is nervous. Someone feels anxiety. Maybe he's unsure of something. This is usually only bad habit, but it could mean that someone is nervous. It could mean it. It could also mean anger. Someone did something to himself or to someone else. Looking at your lips, if intensely, finding it difficult to understand you. If someone of the opposite sex is looking at your lips frequently, they are unconsciously assessing the pleasure that they would get if they were kissing you. If you notice other signs of romantic interest in their body language, you may want to flirt back. Remember what we learned. Pupils are dilated. This is the most easiest romantic interest you can see. And remember about the blinking. Eyebrows, eyes. Combine this. Someone constantly looking at your lips, looking at your body and the opposite sex. Oh, come on, it's so easy. The hair. Twirling hair around finger. This means that someone is nervous, or if it is a woman, she is showing other flirting cues, she could be interested in you. Touching their hair, not twirling. This could mean relaxed. Rearranging their hair, showing your opinion of them matters. If it is a man and he is showing other flirting cues, he is preening. Showing romantic interest, but only if this is a man and this can be related to woman. That a woman is attractive to him. But now, I would have to say to other parts of this tutorial are pretty much heavy to understanding. Now, I will process some more stuff in my next tutorial, because there were already too much info in the last tutorial, and we'll finish the face in the next tutorial. In the tutorial after that, we will talk about body, you know, our body. What does the body do? That is what we will talk about. Now enjoy this tutorial. Subscribe, like, do whatever. Apply this in real life. Find the good people in your life and remember, nothing is as it seems. This works maybe for 80% of people, not for everybody. This is only beginning. Ask for cues. Ask for signs. You will find them in the end. It is not that hard, believe me. Greetings.